Please, sit down. Welcome, everyone. I must apologize for dragging you all here at such an uncommon hour, but from what I've been told, this matter needs to be dealt with urgently. So urgently, in fact, probably should have been addressed weeks ago, but that is spilt milk under the bridge. So, why doesn't somebody tell me what they think is going on here?
Mr. Tulda, as I mentioned earlier, if you compare the figure at the top of page 13...
Jared, it's a little early for all that. Just speak to me in plain English.
Okay.
In fact, I'd like to speak to the guy who put this together. Mr. Sullivan, is it? Does he speak English?
Sir?
I'd like to speak with the analyst who seems to stumble across this mess.
Certainly. That would be Peter Sullivan, right here.
Oh, Mr. Sullivan, you're here. Good morning. Maybe you could tell me what you think is going on here. And please, speak as you might to a young child, or a golden retriever. It wasn't brains that got me here, I can assure you of that.
Well, sir, as you may or may not know, I work here for Mr. Rogers as an associate in the Risk Assessment and Management Office at MBS.
Please, just relax, stand up, tell us in a clear voice what is the nature of the problem.
Okay, well, as you probably know, over the last 36 to 40 months, the firm has begun packaging new MBS products that combine several different tranches of rating classification in one tradable security. This has been enormously profitable, as I imagine you noticed.
I have.
Well, the firm is currently doing a considerable amount of this business every day. Now, the problem, which is, I guess, why we are here tonight, is that it takes us, the firm, about a month to layer these products correctly, thereby posing a challenge from a risk management standpoint.
And Mr. Sullivan, that challenge is?
Well, we have to hold these assets on our books longer than we might ideally like to.
Yes.
But the key factor here is these are essentially just mortgages, so that has allowed us to push the leverage considerably beyond what you might be willing or allowed to do in any other circumstance, thereby pushing the risk profile without raising any red flags.
Now, thank you, Mr. Sullivan. Sit down. What I'm guessing your report here says, and give me some rope here. What I'm guessing it says is that, considering the, shall we say, bumpy road we've been on the last week or so, that the figures your brilliant co-workers up the line ahead of you have come up with don't make much sense anymore, considering what's taking place today.
Actually, not what's taking place today, but what's already taken place over the last 2 weeks.
So you are saying this has already happened?
Sort of.
And Mr. Sullivan, what does your model say that that means for us here?
Well, that's where it becomes a projection. But,
You're speaking with me, Mr. Sullivan.
Well, sir, if those assets decrease by just 25% and remain on our books, that loss would be greater than the current market capitalization of this entire company.